Good morning, my dear children and parents. Welcome to class 7th of Indus Valley Public School. Here in your class, we have completed with the lesson number 2 from your honeycomb, A Gift of Chapels, written by Vasantha Surya. My dear children, we have studied A Gift of Chapel as a story that reflects childhood, brotherhood and kindness. In this, we have 9 characters: Mridu, Meena, Ravi, Lali, Kitten, that is cat, Tapi, Rukmini, Music Master and Beggar. So we have seen that Mridu visited Rukmini's house and her cousins, and we have seen that how children had maintained the secrecy about the kitten from their elders. Ravi managed to bring milk for the kitten by saying that he is hungry. Lali was learning music, that is violin, by music master, who was pony figured wearing golden chain and the diamond ring. Then a beggar used to come daily at their house for last whole week for the alms, but this time he received a pair of chappals as a gift and was very happy and went away immediately. This pair of chappal was of music master, as they were given by Ravi to the beggar. Now on this, Rukmini had to give Gopu Mama's new chappals to the music master, and again it becomes a gift for him. So we have seen twice there was a gift of chappals. First it was for the beggar who was really in need of it, and second time it was for the music master, and for him it was a prestige. So my dear children, this is what was there in your whole story. So now in this video, we are going to do the summary of the lesson as well as the question answers. So here we are going to start with the summary. First, introduction. This is the story about the children where they had reflected their kindness, jauntiness, that means funny nature, and brotherhood. We learned that children's minds are much simpler than those of grown-ups. We have 9 characters: Mridu, Ravi, Meena, Lali, Rukmini, she is Mridu's aunt, Tapi, Mridu's grandfather, Tata, Mridu's grandfather, M.P. Punai, that is cat, music master and the beggar. Now here is the summary from the first part of the lesson. One afternoon, Mridu went to her aunt Rukmini's house. She went there to meet her cousin Lali, Ravi and Meena. So on one day, Mridu with her went to visit aunt Rukmini along with her Tapi, and there she met with her cousins Lali, Ravi and Meena. So there were 3 cousins of Mridu. Ravi dragged her to the backyard. So as soon as she entered, who entered? Mridu entered. Ravi immediately took her to the backyard. There, inside a torn football, lay a very small kitten drinking milk. So why he took Mridu to the backyard? Because he wanted to show her the small kitten that they had taken today in the morning, and she was there inside the torn football and was licking milk. Who was licking milk? Cat was licking milk. Meena said they had found the creature outside the gate that morning. So where they found the cat? They found the cat outside the gate on that particular morning. But it was kept secret. So this was a secret. What was the secret? Secret was that they had a kitten in their backyard. This was the secret. They had a fear that Pati would go away if she knows about the cat in the house. So why they are maintaining the secret? They are maintaining the secret because if Pati will know that there is a cat, then she will immediately go away from the home and she will not stay back for longer time. Ravi had succeeded in getting a little milk for the kitten. So Ravi used to manage to get the milk for the kitten by saying that he was hungry. The children named it Mahendran. So name of the cat was Mahendran. It was a fine breed of cat. Ravi gave a detailed account of cat's family and relative. He said the cat was the descendant of the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat. So now Ravi is telling about the origin of the cat, and finally he told that it is the descendant of Mahabalipura Rishi cat. Meena and Mridu smiled at his cooked up story. So now Meena and Mridu is thinking that it is not the real story, it is the story created by Ravi about the cat. So they were laughing and they were smiling on the story that was created by Ravi. The cat was frightened to hear Ravi's sound. So what? Cat was not comfortable with the Ravi's sound. He fled from his place. Lali was learning to play the violin. She wasn't doing well, although the music master was trying his best to make her learn. So what happened? So Lali was learning music, that is violin, and she was not able to play nicely. Even though the music master was trying his best to make her learn, but she was not able to learn it properly, that violin. What she was learning? She was learning violin. Okay, children. Now coming to the second part of the lesson. So now what happened in the second part? The beggar is there. How? In the second part, we will be knowing about how chappal become a gift and how the lesson title is appropriate. Okay. So Mridu went up to the window. So she saw Lali sitting with her violin. In front of her, there was the bony music teacher. He had a mostly bald headed. He was wearing a gold chain around his neck and a diamond ring on his hand. A beggar came to the gate. The mother told Ravi to send him away. She was chatting with Tapi. She was talking to Tapi. So now what happened? So now when a sound came, so Mridu and all other three, they stood at the window, and what they saw? They saw that Lali was learning music and she was sitting in front of a music master, and the structure description of music master is very thin. He was having bald headed, and he was wearing a golden chain and having a golden ring. So this is what the description of the music master. Then what happened? All of a sudden, a beggar came at the gate, and then mother told Ravi, as soon as she came to know there is a beggar, so mother told Ravi, ask him to go away today, as Rukmani was talking to her Tapi. The beggar's voice irritated her. So every now and then beggar is calling Amma, 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 because he wants some help. So the voice, the noise that was created by him irritated her. Whom? Rukmani. She complained that he was coming there every day. So now she is saying that every day he used to come here. The beggar was already in the garden. So he was there in the garden. He had spread a piece of cloth under the neem tree. He leaned against the tree trunk waiting for the alms. So now the beggar was already inside the garden and he put a cloth, put something under the neem tree and make himself to rest against the trunk of the tree. And he was waiting for the help. Alms mean help. Ravi told him sternly, that means strictly, to go away. The beggar sat up and sighed, became very sad. Why he was sad? Because Ravi asked him to go away and today he will not get any kind of alms. The beggar sat up and sighed, became very sad. He told that he would go away after taking some rest. So now beggar is saying, okay, I'll move, but give me some time so that I can rest. The tar had melted on the hot road and his bare feet got blisters. Now beggar is showing his feet and saying that the road tar is melted and because of that I got blisters on my feet. The children got sympathetic. They became concerned. Unko daya aa gayi towards him. Why? Because he said that he is having boils or he is having what? Boils. He got blisters because of that road. Because road was very hot. Ravi, Mridyu and asked Meena and Ravi if they had got a pair of old slippers in the house. Now Mridyu is asking Meena and Ravi whether they are having any pair of slippers. Ravi went to search. Mridyu noticed a pair of chappals in the veranda. So when Mridyu entered the house, she saw a pair of slippers that was not in a very good condition. It was too many marks were there. But she noticed and she remembered about that chappal. These were shabby looking but sturdy. So now she is saying that this chappal is very shabby, that means untidy and very strong. He gave it to the old man to wear and asked him to never come back again. So now Ravi gave that chappal to the beggar and asked him that not to come till the time there, not to come again, go and take away the slipper. He gave it to the old man to wear and asked him to never come back. The beggar blessed the children. So after getting the chappal, he blessed all the children. He pushed his feet into the slipper and left in a hurry. So he left in the hurry. Why? Because he was thinking that if somebody from the house would come out and if they will see him, then they might snatch the slipper. So in order the slipper should not get snatched, he moved immediately in order to become safe. The music master searched for his chappals in the veranda. Now after completing his class, music master starts searching for his slippers. He said his slipper was brand new and expensive also. Now he is telling about his slipper, that it was very brand new and the formation of the chappal and description of the chappal was very good. He said it's very costly and very expensive and it was very new. Rukmani came there with Pati. So now Rukmani is coming with her mother Pati. She rightly guessed that it was mischief played by the children. Now Rukmani is thinking that this kind of mischief is only being played by the children. She rightly guessed that it was a mischief played by the children. She was upset and angry. So now after knowing that these things are done by the children, she became upset and angry. She went indoor and brought Kopu Mama's new chappals and gave them to the music master. So now Rukmini entered the house and from the cupboard she brought a new pair of chappals that belongs to Mama, Gopu Mama, and she gave it the same chappals to the music master. She apologized, said sorry, to the master on the behalf of his son, Ravi. The music master's eyes lit up with joy, but he had not shown his happiness to them. Why? Because he's already credited that his chapel was very new and it is very costly as compared to whatever he get. He put them on and called children naughty monkey. So after viewing it, he started calling them monkey, that too naughty monkey. The mother did not like Ravi being called monkey. So my mother did not like that the beggar or the man should call him Vaidhi thing. So now she went inside the house. She thanked God that Gopu Mama's chapel were there. So now what happened? So when the music master called Ravi as monkey, so mother did not like that music master should call him as a monkey. So now what happened? She went inside the house. She thanked the God that Gopu Mama's chapel were there. But she laughed to think how much upset would he be on his return. So here he is, Gopu Mama. She declared that she would take all the blame on herself. Now she decided when Gopu Mama will ask about the incident, then at that point of time, she is going to take all kind of blames. Okay, children, this is what you have studied in your lesson, A Gift of Chapels. So in this way, we have seen how chapels became the gift. Now coming to the question answers. Question number one, what is the secret? These are the comprehension questions. What is the secret that Meena shares with Mridu in the backyard? Meena told Mridu about the small kitten which was lying inside a torn football lined with sacking and filled with sand, lapping milk from a coconut half shell. She told Mridu that they found outside the gate that morning and that a secret which their mother did not know. Question number two, how does Ravi get milk for the kitten? Ravi told his mother that he was hungry and wanted to drink milk. The mother gave him and asked him to keep the tumbler back. Ravi told that he would wash it himself and finishing the milk after finishing the milk. And this was how he got the milk for kitten. Question number three. Who does say kitten's ancestors are? Do you believe him? The kitten's ancestors were the Pallava's lion, the Mahabalipuram Rishi cat, which was the emblem of Pallava's dynasty. The Mahabalipuram Rishi cat was a descendant of the cat goddesses of Egypt. No, we do not believe it. Or if you believe it, you have to give the instance from the story. Question number 4. Ravi has a lot to say about M.P. Purnai. This shows that what? So, four options were there. So, what it shows? So, it shows his knowledge of history is sound. He has a rich imagination. He is an intelligent child. So, all these 3 points matching with the answer. What was the noise that startled Mridu and frightened Mahendran? So, what was the sound? Lali was learning to play violin and the sound of screech coming from it startled Mridu and frightened Mahendran. Question number 6. The music master is making lovely music. Read aloud the sentences in the text that express this idea. The music master's notes seem to float up and settle perfectly into the visible track of the melody. It was like the wheel of the train fitting smoothly into rails and whizzing along. Had the beggar come to Rukmani's house for the first time? Give reason for your answer. No, the beggar had been coming for a week to Rukmani's house. Pati herself said that he had been coming there every day for the past week and that was the time he should find another house to beg from. So now Pate is saying that he is continuously coming in that house. Now he should search another house for the
begging or any kind of help. A sharp V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrow. What does it suggest to you about Rukmini's mood? A V-shaped line had formed between her eyebrow. This suggests that Rukmini was very angry and annoyed when she came to know that chappals of the music teacher were missing. Now, working with the text, these are the questions at the back. Complete the following sentences and fill in the blanks are there. So, I have completed the sentence. Ravi compared Lali's playing the violin to the derailing of a train going completely off track. Trying to hide beneath the tray of chilies, Mahendran tipped the few chilies over himself. So, now cat has some chilies over his hand, over himself. The teacher played the few notes on his violin and Lali stumped behind him on her violin, which looked quite helpless and unhappy in her hand. The beggar said that the kind ladies of the household had felt his body and soul together, feed his body and soul together on for a whole week, and he couldn't believe that they would turn away. So, like on the last day when he got the slipper, he used to get alms from the Pati as well as Rukmini, but this time he did not get any kind of help. Okay, so this is there. After the lesson was over, the music teacher asked Lali whether she had seen chappals. So now, after completion of the chapter, music master started searching for his chappals, and he asked Lali for the same. So now, after lesson was over, the music master asked Lali whether she has seen the chappals. Okay, fine. Question number 2. Describe the music teacher as seen from the window. Now you have to give the description. So it is, the music teacher as from the window was a bony figure having a mostly bald headed with a fringe of oil back, black hair falling around his ears and an old fashioned tuft. A gold chain gleamed around his leathery neck and the diamond ring glittering on his hand as it glided up and down the stem of the violin. जैसे ही स्टेम जो आप वायलिन बजाते हो डंडे से वो ऊपर नीचे होता हाथ, उसी तरह से रिंग भी ऊपर नीचे हो रही थी. ओके, एंड अ डायमंड रिंग ग्लिटरिंग ऑन हिज हैंड एंड इट ग्लाइडेड अप एंड डाउन द स्टेम ऑफ द वायलिन. अ लार्ज फुट स्टक आउट फ्रॉम बीनीथ हिज गोल्ड बॉर्डर्ड वेस्टी. वेस्टी इज अ साउथ इंडियन टर्म फॉर धोती. Edge, and he was beating time on floor with this crowny big toe. So from his toe he was tapping the music. What would Mridu conclude that the beggar has no money to buy chappals? What does this suggest to show her concern? So now question number next ka first part. When the beggar stretched out his feet to show the large pink peeling blister on the sole of his bare feet, Mridu concluded that beggar has no money to buy chappals. Next is there. What does this suggest to show her concern? So, how did Mridu show his concern? Mridu asked Ravi and Meena to get a pair of slippers for the beggar in order to show her concern for them. Next question. Have you children? She began, and then seeing they are curiously quiet, went on more slowly. She seen everyone lurking around the veranda. So the question, what do you think Rukmini really wanted to ask? Rukmini really wanted to ask the children if they had picked up and hide the music teacher's chappals. Next question number 2. Why did she change her question? So she changed her questions on seeing the hidden curiosity quite an innocence. Question number next. On getting Gopu Mama's chappal, the music master, your music teacher tried not to look too happy. Why? The music teacher's chappals were old and dirty. On getting Gopu Mama's new chappals, he was happy but tried to look not too happy, as he did not want to show happiness to the house members and others. House members and moreover wanted to prove that his own chappals were much more better than expensive than those he got, and thus was compromising on them. On getting a gift of chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute. Why was he such a hurry to leave? On getting a gift of chappals, the beggar vanished in a minute because he did not want anyone of the elder member of the house to come and know about it. He must have feared that if anyone would come, they would snatch the gift from him. Question number 7.
Now coming to the last question of the lesson. Question number 7. Walking towards the kitchen with Mridu and Meena, Rukmini began to laugh. What made her laugh? So now answer is, on thinking about Gopu Mama's reaction, Rukmini laughed. She was imagining the scene in the evening when Gopu Mama would come from his work and would look for his chappals and will come to know that his chappals were given to the music teacher as a gift. So my dear children, here we are ending with the lesson. You will write down summary, extra questions, question answers, comprehension checks in your notebook, and everyone will show me your notebook after completion of the chapter, and you will send me the snaps of the photographs to my WhatsApp number. Okay, so just read it properly. Any doubt, please do call me up and clear your doubt immediately. Okay children, so bye, take care, and thank you so much.